driven there. Can anybody come up with a recommendation on what Jerry has just said? So we can make note that we have a seconder, and I'm sure we can accommodate that, Jerry. I'm sure we can.
On that, can I just come in on that and say that I'm a bit worried about doing things like that, only because we are only one committee looking at one director. If we start saying to the cabinet, look, we don't agree with £500,000 of these options, they've only got 1 million leeway anyway, so does that put other committees such as health and wellbeing and transformation and resources at disadvantage? I'd be wary about doing something like that only because with these issues, obviously these are the chief exec options, nothing set in stone yet. So I just urge caution on that.
Right.
No, I agree, John. John, please, hang on, Jeff. Hang on, we've got two people here who indicated they want to speak. So they're going to speak first, and then I'll come to you, Jerry, and anybody else who wants to speak. But it is within the remit of this committee to make recommendations. But yes, if we do decide not to close toilets, it will mean that we do have to go and look at something else. But if these are only, as Kevin said before, these are only, at this stage, recommendations. So if there are any recommendations from either side of the room, people who want it, I mean, Rob, you made a half-hearted attempt as a recommendation before.
Do
you want to get it in
touch with
Rob? Rob, please, Jerry, please. If you want to get a second there, if you want to make a recommendation, we can accommodate it, and then we can vote on it. It is within the remit of this committee to do that.
So I have one quick question and another non-support question. First question is, my right my understanding is that the council is under no legal obligation to provide the community. Is that right?
Yes.
Excellent. Secondly, back to this parking lot and the parks. Is there going to be, any study as to the displacement of vehicles into residential areas around the parks or not before the decision is made on parking?
For you, Chair, whereas before the option did look at that issue in the panel meeting on parks, the issue didn't come out, and that isn't something to be flagged in the state as far as I'm aware.
I'm just thinking, is that a no then? Because I'm thinking you've got.
Yes, it is a no.
Well, the question then is, can we have one? That's my
conclusion. I'll second that.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you, Chair. Certainly a very quick comment, but if I've read this correctly, going back to square one, we're looking at a series of options, all of which we are not required to employ. So all we're doing here is trying to decide which of those options are least attractive to the assembled company here and to make those statements clearly to the cabinet member before the decision. Just wanted to clarify that for you, Mark, because I think we were going off at half cocks on that. We do not have to accept any or all of these options. We only need to accept some of them, and it's the ones that we agree are a priority, along with what has been said in the consultation. But hopefully we'll get the decision made when cabinet. I think that's just worth clarifying.
Thank you. Yes, David, thank you. Yes, there's the Chief Exec's recommendations, and there is scope in there to reject some. But if there is a scope in there, his recommendations come to more than we have to cut this year. So there is scope. And as groups, I would hope we will all be discussing this. And as Jerry said, cabinet members are all sitting at the back there listening intently to what's being said. It is good that the cabinet members are sitting there and they do make an effort to come to these meetings. Because these meetings are important. They are important.
Chair, just to build on that, just counsel out to this point, the budget options that we've been asking to sort of think we're asking for cabinet to council
the same thing, no? Well, let's do this one first then, Jerry, and then you can come in with yours. Okay, so did everybody hear that? Does everybody understand that?
No, we didn't. Tell me that one.
Jerry.
Jerry's
been on Forge Pair Rock. So, for clarification, we've had one recommendation about the public toilets, and we've had one recommendation about porch. Porch and rock.
This gentleman here also said he wanted to serve on the
displacement of the traffic.
Well, we haven't had a recommendation on that, and we haven't voted on that.
Well, we had a recommendation, I think, seconded would be my second of it.
I've missed that completely. Can we do that again now, Beth, please?
Can I just ask, if we were to go to a traffic survey on the country park option, would that mean it would be taken as a budget option like that in the sort of over there? Sorry, just to clarify, do we have the time to do the survey before it goes to cabinet?
Incredible that you can make the statements.
Put your recommendations through our second.
Okay. Recommendation is that we do a survey to see about the displacement of the traffic now on Wallasey Jetty.
Jenny, please. Apart from anything else, it's really bad management. This will get a unanimous on.
I'll second.
I've done second him before it's come.
A guy from the chair, Chapter, who that they they don't support having petitions, but they have other committee members who are also coming against it. Five people actually addressed the committee with objections, and there was one in favour, who was Mr. Reeves, who was one of the assistant directors at the Magenta, living who would, were hoping to obtain this land and be developed. After listening to all the evidence that was put before us and studying the maps that were given to us, we unanimously decided to get against the decision of the officers, and we declined.
Thanks, Steve. Anyone want to make any comments on that? No? Okay, that's fine. Thank you. Thanks very much for that, Steve. That brings us on to any other business. There is one item on any other business which I'd like to bring up, and it's to do with the Liverpool City region. There was a meeting last week of the scrutiny panel. Again, I was in hospital, and I'm a member of the scrutiny panel along with Anita Leach and John Hare. And as Anita attended, and I didn't. I'd like Anita just to bring us up to date about what's happened, and then I'll make a brief comment before we finish. And I don't know why John has decided to stand down, but I've got a feeling I'm going to die. And I'll just make a brief comment on that before we finish. So Anita, please.
Okay, thanks, Chair. It was a fairly short meeting where we did the appointment of the Chair and the Vice Chair. Councillor Kevin Wainwright from Polton Council was elected unopposed as chair. Councillor Andy Moorhead from Billerley was elected unopposed as vice chair. Then there was the appointment of members to the Combined Authority Audit Committee, in which there were two places, and Councillor Paulette Lapping from Sefton Council was appointed, and Councillor Patrick Curley from Liverpool Council. We also talked about the Combined Authority Forward Plan. It was an evolving document, and it would be a regular agenda item. And the work programme, the areas that were decided to be included in the work programme were European funding, skills and learning, stroke apprenticeships, housing, affordable transport links. And from the panel's work programme, the panel members would be invited to the top meetings rather than form working groups. However, it was felt that there might at some stage be like task finish groups breaking down the whole group into smaller groups. There was a decision on four formal meetings taking place in July, October, January and April, but those dates are still to be finalised. And the last comment I was going to make was that John Hare has returned to the panel.
Thanks, Anita. Thank you. I'd just like to add, there was a recommendation made when these city regions were brought about by central government, and I think it is a forward way of moving, and there will be funding available through the city regions. I still can't bring myself to call it the Liverpool City Region.
Yeah.
And it was felt that it would be appropriate, as we've got the makeup the region are predominantly Labour dominated, that we have a member of one of the opposition parties as chair of the scrutiny. And from an individual point of view, only from my point of view, I thought that was a very sensible way of moving forward. So I am very disappointed. I thought John, who would have put his name forward as to chair the committee, I think John would have made an excellent chair of the scrutiny group, but it wasn't in my hands or whatever. It was put to a vote, and the other members of the committee voted in favour of the chair being, a Labour councillor, which I do regret. That's it. And I'm only talking as an individual, and I'm very sorry to hear that John stepped down, because I think he would have made a very useful member of the committee. So I'm very disappointed that he's felt, I can understand why he's done it, but I am disappointed that he's felt he needed to do that. So, yeah, okay. Well, thanks very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That concludes our meeting for tonight.